Wow, that went well.
Дурдом какой-то.
That was amazing. Oh. What? Okay. This game just wants me dead. Where's it gonna put me? It hit me before the This game just wants me dead so hard. I can't even. Oh man. I can't get mad at that. How can you get mad at something like that? That's just hilarious. I probably should have reset when I died in Chapter 4 anyway, but that was just hilarious. I mean, how do you even get mad at something like that? Okay, let's start again. 6053 is not a bad in-game time. In-game time does not count deaths, by the way. Every time you die, it resets your in-game time to whatever it was prior to your last checkpoint. So, you cannot trust the IGT. It was very useful for segmented, for what I did with segmented, though. Because I could pretty much die as many times as I wanted to jump in the segment. But for single segment, you gotta stick to RTA. And this is my stretch break! You know, you don't usually think of the helicopter segments as, like, stretch breaks, but your stretch break. I mean, 2.5 minutes. This game is what's giving me a big old middle finger. And I know that some speedrunners out there, you know, they get really contentious when they're doing this thing. They get really pissy. But me, I just think it's hilarious.
Adams! Schmee!
To an extent. And I do get angry with the occasion. It is pretty funny. So, I hope you're enjoying yourself. The hilarious misadventures of Captain Walker of the Kremlin. By the way, it also turns out I did test that you actually don't need to shoot any of the helicopters in the Chapter 12 version of this either. Although you do need to shoot the side weapons also. But you don't need to shoot the helicopters in the movie. Just the side weapons. I tried that in testing because I had previously been too scared to try and shoot the stretch break. Anyway, stretch breaks on the forward. You see that helicopter crashing? There it is. Hello, helicopter. Hi, helicopter. Nice knowing you. But yeah, I am recording a game-only local recording at the same time as this for my YouTube channel.
Помните, что тут официально никого нет. Нас тоже никогда не было. Действуем по инструкции.
I'm pretty sure that the game just takes away your sprint once you get to this piece of cover.
Ух ты! Что случилось в Дубае, тут и остается.
Ура!
Довольно, Луга.
Я просто шучу, босс.
Отставить юмор. У нас боевая задача.
Also, I'm playing this at 720p with the game's graphics turned down to the lowest setting, and it still looks really good.
Выходим на связь. Штаб высылает отряд.
I think it's more of a testament to the game's art direction.
Эй, вы слышали это?
Подкалываешь?
Обижаешь, приятель.
Cause my PC is perfectly capable of running this game at 1080p with all of the graphics settings turned up to max, but for streaming and local recording at the same time, I have to bring it down a bit. And for loading times, kind of, I mean, it doesn't really affect it, Unreal Engine 3 pretty well optimized for PC.
Штаб велел осмотреться, вот мы и смотрим.
Не знаю,
могли найти дело получше для умных и сильных
красавцев. Считали, что ты вот уже человек.
На будущее знай. Я люблю пляжи.
Oh, I also didn't mention before, but one-handed weapons are faster than two-handed weapons. And there are only four one-handed weapons in the game. There's the M9, there's the Micro 9mm, there's the Desert Eagle, and then there's the Magnum that that Riggs gives you in Chapter 11. And those are the only one-handed weapons in single player. Aside from that, there are no other one-handed weapons. So I always want to make sure that I have at least one one-handed weapon in my arsenal at all times so that I can run with it. Although I keep the M4A1 out here just so that I can start the next section with it. I'm over here! Yeah, it's only in... I'm not resetting over that. Micro 9 until I get the Desert Eagle, at which point I exclusively use the Desert Eagle, and then I stick with the Magnum. So yeah, Micro until Chapter 6, and then Desert Eagle until the Magnum, and then Desert Eagle after I lose the Magnum. God, this is sloppy. But I'll take it. But yeah, it's Micro until Chapter 6. And at that point, the game gives you the Desert Eagle. And then I just stick with the Beagle. The Beagle is great because it can gut shot. Okay, let's see if I can actually save time here. Now that I've sort of explained up until like Chapter 6, up until Chapter 5, I'm gonna just focus on Blank for now. Yeah, I'm gonna lose time here. Yikes. Oh well. But yeah, this game's despawn system is a little inconsistent, but if you could just memorize like what fights despawn and what fights you have to fight through, then it's pretty consistent. No. His sprinting is infinite. Ooh, I got lucky there. Yeah, I explained about crouch blocking, I think, already. Yeah, crouch walking is considerably faster than just the regular slow walk. Like I said, killing the guy up here is not mandatory, but it's very helpful. Here, because this is just based on kills, I'm gonna make the point of specifically having two-handed weapons. Yeah. It was a tie between French and Russian. I flipped a coin and it ended up coming out Russian. Okay, there we go. Sandstorm approaches. That was actually really good. Like, it could almost be gold, I think. Gold! Woo! It's been a long time since I've gotten to Gold Chapter 2.
Adam, слуга, отзовитесь!
Я здесь.
Слушай, ты цел?
Я же сказал,
Ты что, когда вставали? Я хочу понять, где мы.
Кажется, как раз в том отеле, куда направлялись.
И как нам выбираться?
Yeah, the AK I want to replace. The micro mine, replace for the micro 9.
Черт, заперто. Мы в ловушке.
Да уж попали. Враг прицели, стреляем.
Okay, that's good. Sloppy, but I'll take it.
Не думаю. Слушай,
там что-то происходит.
As long as I don't die here again. I gotta play it a little safe, jumping down, to avoid the death that I had last time. You still here, Kelly?
Adam's dead! No! Слышали?
Кто
заряжаю? Прячьтесь.
Взрывчатка?
Чёрт, на крыше! На крыше!
That's more like it. I had a bad fight, which is why I'm losing time. That's a lot less time than I lost last time, so... Much better. I had like a godly fight last time. My chapter 3 hotel fights are not good, so...
Примерно с тех пор, как начались бури.
Жизнь борьба, но это не дает права убивать солдат.
Американец явно дал им такое право. Так, все за мной.
Yeah, let's go do our grenade launcher strats again. Walker only settles. Walker only deals with the best of diplomatic tactics, like the upstanding soldier that he is.
Их просто перебили всех.
Не, смотри, их построили. Слышали?
За мной, и тихо.
Мы будем продолжать.
Оп.
Пристрелил.
Gotta grab these,
Адамс, обыщи труп.
Yeah, check the body. The gibbed body that I just exploded with my grenade launcher. Sure. Go check it. What's left of it.
Ни хрена себе. Это же добро ЦРУ.
Наверное, это их база.
Прикрываться гражданскими? Не очень-то по-мужски.
В духе ЦРУ.
Да, но вот стрельба по своим нет.
Тот боец привел бы нас к Конраду.
Да, или в засаду.
Да ладно?
Nah, I prefer to use RPGs.
Это мой выбор. И мне с ним жить.
Grenade launchers just don't have the same impact.
Все назад.
So you can't sprint during this section? I don't know if I made that clear in the past, but you can't sprint for like the first 10 seconds or so after you first beat the soldiers. That was a really good fight against the 33rd.
Найти, пока здесь не оказалось больше солдат.
Больше американских солдат.
Дезертиров.
И что делать?
Чтобы в этом разобраться, нам нужно найти Конрада.
Это поможет? Его батальон дезертировал.
Конрад всегда был человеком чести. Может, батальон и спятил, но полковник тут точно ни при чем.
С чего ты взял?
Потому что я его знаю. Так, открывай.
Без вопросов.
It's been a much better start so far. Like I said, I mean, most of the time that I lost in my PB was like mid to end game. I had a really good start. And like I said, end of chapter 4, just because of the new strats, I could save like another minute and a half at least. Even with that stupid cover thing. That sometimes happens. I gotta wait. That was just dumb. I got stuck. I forgot about that. It hasn't happened in so long. I lost like 15 seconds. Nothing, no big deal. I got stuck on the geometry. I totally forgot that could happen. This game really does not like me today. Okay, I'm gonna take like a couple extra steps before I vault over that staircase. Like right there. There we go, much better. Much better. I hope he saw that, holy. Oh dear. That, thankfully there was a checkpoint right there, so First death. I'm not gonna complain too much about that. The good news is that when you die here, the enemies don't actually spawn. They spawn like over there. Oh, and I didn't get the execution, even better. Even with that, oh god, my good chapter 5s are going to be something else. Yeah, my good chapter 4s are going to be something else. Also, I hope you like my split names.
Сигнал идет оттуда, из глубины.
Проклятые забросили крючок. Пора вытащить.
Это же ловушка.
Несомненно. Но весь город сошел с ума. Дэниелс наша единственная надежда.
Alright. Time to focus.
Последний.
Это они!
No. Okay, one death. It was early, so I'll take it. At this point, I've got so many, late game strats that I can afford to... All those guys despawn when you go past the staircase, by the way, which is why I'm running past them. Actually past that area. All right, I'll take that. I will gladly take that.
Прежде всего надо снять этих снайперов.
Did I actually kill any of them? It did. Kind of.
Смотреть в оба! Теперь идем. Быстро и тихо.
Черт! Там вертушка!
Я понял!
Здоровая дура, верно? Ага, и ее дружки точно знают про денег на подходе!
Они прут прямо! Осторожно!
Фраг убит!
Hi, that Costa Rican guy. Looks pretty good. Because I happen to like its gameplay. And I'm generally an optimistic person, so my optimism is generally deterrent against the game's relentless pessimism. Oh crap, I forgot to get weapons before doing this. Usually I want the LMG during this session. So runners are one hit kills on Fubar, by the way. That was horrible when I was speedrunning this game on Fubar. Here I don't really need to worry about ammo preservation. I do need to worry about life preservation. But ammo preservation not so much, because the game will take away your ammo at the end of chapter 5. I assume that at least some of these, at least some of this time loss comes from. I think, yeah, I had a death earlier. That's why.
Идем через здание.
Проклятые, они же вроде герои, но с пытками переборщили.
Если этот диджей у них за главного, ничему не удивлюсь.
С чего ты взял?
So yeah, I timed my crouch walks specifically, because I knew when the slow walk would end there.
Я с ним не общался. Ну тогда поищем выход.
Впереди дверь. Наверное, выход.
So here we go. You remember this part. This part's fun.
Адам, слуга, слышите?
Even on walk on the beach, this part can be difficult.
Нет сигнала. Все лучше и лучше.
Ah!
А что, похоже? Бегом
сюда!
What's
up with the Oh, there we go. This part took me about 400 tries on FUBAR, when I was speedrunning this game on FUBAR, by the way. And the part after this took about 500. Another conversation I could skip by doing restart for checkpoints right now. Crossing that next bridge was usually for this next segment was what screwed me over, but that is why I left the Desert Eagle. Not till chapter 9. We're still on chapter 6. Chapter 8 is when And I got the glitch. Lugo is really angry at God, so he keeps shooting at God during this part. And crouch walking through the bodies. Gotta get really close to the smell of the bodies to really appreciate the beauty of death. Anyway, did you manage to find my FUBAR speedrun at all? I suggest checking that out, because that took a while to make. Alright, hopefully I can get this part decently. That was perfect. Perfect. Let's see how bad of a singer Russian Radio Man is. Oh, he's not bad. Do without first. And then with. That'd be my recommendation. So here's normally you have to shoot the door with the 4-1-7, but because I have M4A1 ammo, I could shoot the door with the M4A1 first. And save the 4-1-7 ammo for later. God, it actually does damage.
Голду не поздоровится.
Что-то не так, Адамс.
Слушай, проклятых нужно остановить. Но
революция.
Эй, он спас нам жизни. И другого выбора у нас нет.
Right there.
Ну-ка, отойдите. Бегом за мной. Живее.
Excellent. That there, I didn't get a bonk. Yeah, this next fight actually has a pretty cool strategy. You're gonna run all the way over to the back of the bus, where usually there's a bunch of 33rd that spawn with the minigun, and we're gonna take the minigun itself. Yes, there is. It's the same OB. It's the same OB as in the console version, as in the PC. And it's just as useless. Pretty neat, though. There's one OB in Chapter 4, and there's an OB in Chapter 1. And they're both useless. They're pretty fun, though. Alright, so here we go. We're gonna run all the way to the other side of the map and take the minigun. Wow, that was a fast spawn. Wow, what a fast spawn! There we go. Wow, that was fast. Okay, so here's a really unusual speed trick. So there's a section here where you're going to raise your gun, but I'm going to continually switch my weapons 10 times, and it's going to skip that part. And it actually saves time, because the raised gun animation would have been slower. And I'm going to try something here. Oh my god, it actually saved time reloading there. So you could probably, so here's the big choice. This is actually kind of interesting. Saving Gould is faster on Walk on the Beach, but on Fubar, saving the civilians is faster, just because of the increased enemy health. So once again, I'm going to restart from checkpoints, just to skip the dialogue between Adams and Lugo, sort of debating between the two choices, and we're going to save Gould. Quote-unquote save Gould, because, you know, he's going to die anyway. Spoilers.
Перезаряжаю!
Черт! Походу к нам в гости!
Адам со мной! Луга, на тебе Гул!
Так точно! Внимание! Движение! Я закрыта, Дельта. Вы в безопасности. Эй, ты! Не высовывайте!
And I got the heavy to spawn already, which is great. Where did it go? There he is.
Просто меня! Идите к воротам!
Not as much as of a beast as, not as much of a beast as the LMG on What's Gonna Be. I'm having a really bad fight. Oh, okay, that wasn't too bad, I guess.
Адамс, Уокер, сюда! Живо!
Уокер, здесь мы как на ладони.
Точно, уходим.
Okay, I guess I had a lot worse of a fight in my PB. Because I just saved a ton of time. Well.
Дерьмо! А ты думал с ними что случится?
We'll see how much time I saved, but...
Идем.
So, you want to see how I speedrun the white phosphorus section? Look at that time save. So, here's how I speedrun the white phosphorus section. There are actual time savers in the white phosphorus section, believe it or not. I forgot that there was a sprint section. I forgot that they could sprint here. Yeah, there are actual speed tricks.
Полагаю, это ворота.
Команда, Уокер, мы ждем.
Готовься стрелять.
Это приказ?
Именно так.
Так.
Wow, my splits have been like a real roller coaster this run.
Камера включена, сэр.
Есть система наведения. Готовы? Огонь!
Я понял тебя.
Готовы, миномет!
Uh-oh, I did it in the wrong order. Should've been left and then right. It's not gonna lose that much time. Hi, Costa Rican guy. Basically, all that matters is that you destroy everything up until you get to the point where that Humvee becomes shootable, where the civilians are. And that you shoot the Hummer as soon as you can. In that sense, it's kind of on a timer, but not really. So we're gonna use the crouch walk to go through the carnage.
Ладно. Закончим. Спускаемся.
And there's an there's also a scripted explosion that we're gonna skip. And then the fight right after is going to be interesting. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 10, 11, 12. Oh, I missed it. Oh well. 12, not 13 steps.
Замолчи.
Что ты сказал? Ты мне на ветре закрой рот, да не вдыхай. Так точно. Боже.
Идем, идем. Идем дальше.
Уокер, ну же.
Ему не помочь.
So there's another slow walk here. And we're gonna skip by shooting once. Time. I was trying to be way too aggressive.
Им некуда отступать. Убейте их! Не подпускайте их!
Очередной противник! Остался!
Есть! Он мертв!
Внимание! Можно не подпишется! Сейчас разберусь!
Противник убит!
Осторожно!
Есть его!
У него дробовик!
Убейте его уже!
Ликвидируйте! Один в неукрытие!
Отлично. Начинайте поиски.
I can get all that time back and then some.
Происходит.
Карты, припасы, патроны. По мне так обычный блокпост.
Нет.
Don't worry, I can get all that time back and then some.
Смени магазин. Неизвестно, что нас там ждет.
Вряд ли будет тяжелее, чем снаружи.
Эй, осторожно, Луго.
Нет, он прав. То, что там произошло, это ужасно. Но нас вынудили. И я знаю, кто. Готовьтесь.
Yeah, so chapter 9 is a pretty laid back chapter. I don't know how I lost 30 seconds on this chapter, but I did somehow.
Что происходит?
Мы ошиблись. Диджей не правит городом.
So that's easy time I can get back.
В смысле?
Это сделал Конрад. Это все он.
Ну, и что делать?
Подыграем ему. Пока.
Also, there's Lugo in the background, who's getting lynched. That's foreshadowing for later.
Когда я служил с ним в Кабуле, он был человеком чести.
Потому что спас вам жизнь. Я многих спас. А умерший еще больше.
Я ничего не понимаю.
Хватит, Уокер.
Да, давай.
Выбор настоящего квартира. Главное верно. Закон потом.
Anyway.
Валим отсюда.
Yeah, this is I have no idea where I lost that time. But there's no reason I should have. So yeah, as I mentioned before, this part's on a timer. There's only a few.
Огонь по крышам вагона!
Я разберусь! Осторожно, у него трубовик! Гранатомет на поясе!
There's only a few people actually bother to kill, like just the earth, just possibly. So I'm just gonna issue, so with the two RPG guys dead, I'm just gonna issue squad orders for the rest of these kills. Lugo. Thank you, Lugo. So yeah, the rest of this is on a timer. I just have to wait for the sandstorm to kick in. So I am pretty low on ammo, but it shouldn't be too much of a problem. So I've got Because I've got stun grenades. Alright, we're good. Gold.
Никого нет, Уокер.
Тогда выдвигаемся.
И куда теперь?
У Конрада наверняка есть наблюдательный пункт, с которого виден весь Дубай. Туда, к самой высокой башне. Вот куда.
Конрад нас заметил, о чем еще говорить?
Я никогда тебя таким не видел.
Я в норме, Адамс. Мы не можем оставить все как есть. Мы не уйдем из Дубая, пока не эвакуируем всех выживших. Нужно, чтобы вы мне верили.
Я верю. Я просто с тобой не согласен.
Похоже, там идет бой.
Твою мать! Если меня кто-то слышит, это Рикс. Мы попали в засаду проклятых. Нужна помощь срочно. Рикс! Черт! Голд рассказал о нем проклятым. Это наша вина. Уокер, хвата голодомет. Кто бы вы ни были, спасибо за помощь. А теперь плотный огонь.
Куда? Сними этого
уроду! Открой дом, идем сюда! Цель уничтожена.
Pretty badly. I haven't really touched them in quite some time. I'm just focusing on this for now. Holy crap, that was good. That was really good.
Jeff Riggs, а теперь быстро внутрь, пока снайпер башку не отстрелил.
Не за что.
Also, I'm playing with Russian.
I've
decided to sort of mix it up with the languages for Spec Ops, because I know that some people think it's boring to just hear fuck shit all the time. So now you can hear fuck shit in multiple languages. Completely forgot about the 417, but that's okay. I could just stick with the LMG for this part. I know the air. I know the map pretty well, so. I'm gonna stick with the LMG for this section because there's a heavy that spawns here, so. Come on, guys, where are you? There's the heavy! Oh no, where is he? There he is. That was amazing. That was not perfect, but it was almost perfect.
Тихо, Луга.
Не мы начали эту войну. Раздача оружия местным не в счет. Стоп.
For a walk on the beach, at least. I mean, I could never do that on Fubar, but...
Есть!
There you guys. I was worried about getting those guys to spawn in my practice runs. Beautiful. That there's a kill plane there if you get there too early. Here's an interesting little glitch. You can run while reloading. And of course I probably screwed up, but that's okay. There are ways to... Yes. And also to make, Lugo and Adam's AI more aggressive. Also, check this out. I'm pretty sure ligaments do not bend that way. In this case, I'm marking them for Adam's Lugo's benefit, though. Here I want a sticky grenade for Zulu Squad. I found this out pretty recently. That was also pretty good. I think the fights in Chapter 10 are pretty self-explanatory for the most part. Although this part could be pretty tough. This next fight coming up. What? Oh! There was guys over there I forgot to kill. On the left side. Totally forgot about those guys! What did I do that for? I completely screwed up my keyboard there. Hit Q when I meant hit W. God. I gotta finish this run. There's still a decent chance I could UV on this. Every so often you can actually get this fight to end too early, like there, for instance.
Они кончились. Давай еще немного. Займитесь машинами. Посмотрю, кто
из. So here I'm gonna try and stealth this section. Quote unquote stealth. Because this game's stealth is broken.
Единственный, кто не пытается нас убить.
Подумай, кому ты помогаешь, капитан.
Alright, here's for the quote-unquote stealth. I only lose like 15 seconds if I don't get it, though. No, I missed it. Okay. Yeah, I only missed like 10 seconds. And I got the checkpoint I wanted anyway, so. I'm convinced that it's like the Russian version of this game, it's dubbed somehow. Also, those guys died because I crossed the kill plane and killed them. Same with that guy over there. And yet somehow I gained like, somehow I didn't lose like almost, I lost like almost no time. Hi Spike Kitty, how you doing? Fine, hold on a second. Yeah, cap percent break. This was probably a good time for it anyway. It's like the only thing I pause for is for my cat. Yes, I understand. I'm gonna get to you right away, okay? Okay, your litter's fixed now. Go on. Go on, your litter's fixed. Yes, it is. Yes. Alright, we're gonna get started. Good thing it had to be during the rail shooter. 3, 2, 1, go. Yay, I saved time. Also, here's Russian Conrad. Or should I say comrade? What the hell? Oh my god, they totally screwed that up. They gave Conrad the radio filter voice for that. That is the worst. Localizers, what the hell? You totally ruined it. Boo, localizers. Another fun fact is that for the English version, Adams, Lugo, and Walker's voice actors were deliberately put in the same room together in order to give them more camaraderie. So we're going to ignore Riggs and also duck walk away from him. I also keep forgetting that there's like 6 extra Magnum bullets.
Walker! Вернись, мать твою!
Ты поступил бы так же.
I still can't believe the Russian dub screwed that up so badly.
Мы видели проклятые. Пришлось бежать. Ну что, ли ты не успел?
Мне повезло.
Рикс?
Труп.
Хорошо.
Нет, плохо. Он нас надул. Из-за него жители Дубая умрут через пару дней. Город нужно эвакуировать как можно скорее.
Интересно, как ты намереваешься это сделать?
Луга?
Ой, прости. Я вас отвлек?
Твою мать. Держись, Луга. Я уже иду.
Не волнуйтесь, тот получит сообщение.
Да пошел ты.
Эй, полегче, привет. Как это семейная радиопередача? Рейтинг для всех жаждущих.
Let's hope I get a good version of this.
Враг убит!
Как всегда! Возвращайся, кто не хотят жить! Перезарядка! Прикройте!
Марти!
Что тебе делать, когда они придут? Эх, Марти, Марти!
Чисто! А у тебя?
Аналогично!
Внимание, 33-й батальон! Распродажа фигурок бойцов Дельты! Повторяю, настоящие фигурки Дельты в торговом центре!
Снова гости! Пора разобраться с этим уродом!
Сначала надо выбраться отсюда! Видите, куда идти?
Здесь некуда! Может пройти дальше?
Меня всерьез прижали!
Стоять! Они готовы!
Also, I think you're gonna like my fight with the the heavy in this area. Just saying. You're really gonna like my fight with the heavy. Although I suggest you don't blink, because you might miss it.
Прикройте меня!
Мы пришли, спасибо!
Стой там, я прикрываю!
Я попробую, ты не сможешь
тебя прикрыть! Не покрытие, пожалуйста! Тебе идут гости!
Yeah, that was the fight with the heavy.
Убейте,
There's a section that gets skipped there because I shot out the door already, in case you're wondering. Of course, it's my tradition. My tradition is to get hit by both Adams and Lugo. Both Adams and Lugo on the way down.
Да пустяки, я в норме. А вы как?
Да, в норме. Слышал?
What the hell was that? I've never seen Lugo's sniper rifle there before. Also, my cat is now wrapped around my foot. So, what'd you think of that heavy fight, eh?
Куда теперь, Луга?
На север, по крышам.
That was pretty special.
Выйдем прямо на него.
Хорошо.
Тихо, летит вертушка. Это снайпер.
Судя по звуку, он рядом. Идем тихо.
Что там?
Опять беспорядки. Гражданские с ума посходили.
Прямо как во время первой...
Давай, мать! Тебе
Лежать, сука! Черт! Прикройте меня!
Мы не болтаем, что мы пришли к реке.
Они в холле! Перезаряжаю! Прикройте!
It actually is difficult because you have to make sure you can shoot him before he teleports, because his teleport location is randomized and he can pretty easily flank you. So here's another interesting little tech. So in this section, normally you're supposed to beat the hell out of this hallucination of Adams. However, you don't need to do the melee at all. You can just shoot him. Saves about 45 seconds.
Если пока можешь, клоун.
Вот и башня.
Сколько стволов на крыше? Черт, я не смогу спуститься до зачистки.
Не вопрос. Адамс, ты указывай...
Контакт! Открыть огонь!
Перезарядка! Луга! Прицельный выстрел! Его!
Черт! Брут со стороны задней двери!
So yeah, the sniper, the Magnum is actually one of the best sniper rifles in the game. Somehow. You can aim the damn thing. It has perfect accuracy.
Луга! Прицельный выстрел! Его! Убей мудака на танцполе! Сосредоточись, огонь! Луга! Сними его!
Принято!
Черт! Прикройте меня! Цель поражена!
Не будь идиотом! Сначала нужно зачистить крышу!
Нет! Аспиранты!
Можешь выдыхать.
Почему
они кончились?
Никто не думает о детях?
And this guy exists just to get popped. Boink! Hello. I'm playing Spec Ops The Line in Russian. Holy crap, this is gonna be an awesome gold.
Слушай задачу, Луга. Через 2 минуты станция должна работать. Понял?
За меня не волнуйся, я свою работу знаю.
Check out that gold!
Луга, как только мы у вертушки, беги к нам!
Обо мне не волнуйтесь, просто идите.
Okay, so there's a crash that can happen here. However, you can avoid the crash. There's a very easy way to avoid the crash. You have to wait for Lugo to snipe a certain enemy, and if he snipes him, then you can avoid the crash.
Разберут в России!
is this guy up here. There, okay, we're good. That was beautiful. So, what do you guys think of this run so far? Do you think this game is an entertaining speedrun? Also, I love Walker's voice acting here. It's amazing what he does, this little yell. I mean, come on, at least Nolan North put some passion into it. It is the absolute opposite of American, actually. By this point, he is destroying the last foundations of any Clinton city. The story pretty much destroys any concept of, like, the Manifest Destiny. If you were playing this in English, you'd understand, but he is... The main character is very much a psychopath. And at this point has pretty much been driven over the edge. And at this point he's pretty much destroying the rest of the city just because he can. You are not supposed to like this guy. Did you get past chapter 8? Okay, well then that would explain why. In fact, the very next chapter is going to be when some of the more mind-stealing stuff comes in. Basically, this guy is not a hero, and, yeah, basically this guy is, the yacht glitch is, in chapter 13, there's a glitch where, when you're holding out on the sandstorm, so when you're holding out on the sandstorm in the yacht in chapter 13, there's a random chance that sometimes, there's a random chance that sometimes the sandstorm won't despawn properly.
Стойте! Стойте, это неправильно!
Слишком поздно!
Но мы ведь это уже сделали!
Смысле?
Твою мать! Снова! Сбросьте их уже!
Принято!
Так, Лейбер! И всё!
So yeah, you don't have to shoot any of the choppers here either. Just the sidewinders.
Adams, жми!
Чуть не попал!
another goal, by the way, I think. Either that or it's gonna be close. There we go, that was the last Sidewinder. Never mind. I thought that was going to be good. Apparently not. Apparently that wasn't nearly as good as I thought it was. I guess it's because I played safe. But I still am at a pretty decent point. Yeah, this is where I lost a ton of time. So I could still... This is where I lost the majority of my time, was on Chapter 13. So this is what I like to call the Burj of Sauron. I have no idea why Conrad's dialogue is so much quieter than the rest of the game. And it only seems to happen on the Russian dub. Like, I've played some of the other foreign dubs, and none of them seem to have this problem. Like, the English dub doesn't have it, French and German... I haven't tested Spanish or Portuguese yet, but Russian doesn't have this problem. So far, Russian is the only one that seems to have this problem with Conrad's dialogue. I don't know why. Yeah, this game definitely deserves at least one full playthrough for everyone who has either a 360, PS3, or a PC that can play it. And it's not spoiling any of the story because it's in Russian. You can't understand it. So, hopefully I can get a good fight here. You remember this part, right?
Полковник.
Что? Это Адамс, твою мать. Ты где вообще?
Пока не знаю. Луга с тобой?
Нет, молчит с момента падения.
Черт. Ты-то сам где?
Иди на дым.
Well, if you want to vote for a language. And just to be safe here, I'm going to restart from checkpoint. Yeah, so we're fighting Zulu Squad. Pretty much exclusively from here on out. Or at least in this chapter. On Fubar, Adam's reaction time is slightly slower. And that of the enemy AI. Holy crap, that was clutch.
Нужно идти, сможешь?
Я в норме.
Хорошо. Сначала найдем Лука, потом
Конрада. It's semi-auto.
Мы еще можем спасти этих людей,
Я не позволю нам помешать.
But it can...
Адамс,
it can... It can fire almost as fast as it can click the left mouse button.
Оружия нет. Рука сломана.
Луга! Черт, он умолк!
Судя по сигналу, он на севере.
Хоть что-то. Идем.
В укрытие!
Внимание, давай!
Там залупный снайпер. Не доставьте,
подойдем. So here's the interesting little trick. I'm gonna use a grenade throw to fake out a bunch of enemies here, and that's actually gonna let me pass by them without having to fight them. Because they're too busy with the grenade. Because their AI will prioritize running away from the grenade over fighting me. That works. I found that on Poobar, and I didn't think it would be that usable, but. Apparently it was usable. Oh my god, am I gonna get Crazy Adams? Please tell me I'm getting Crazy Adams. I think I got Crazy Adams. Oh my god, no. No. There's a glitch called- Yes! Crazy Adams! Yes! Okay, so this is Crazy Adams. He's a glitch where Adams is in combat mode during his during his little speech. And so he just sort of runs off and leaves Walker here. I just think it's funny. It has no bearing on the actual time, but it's hilarious.
Устранить его!
Черт! Удачок с ножом бежит!
Адамс, разберись со жду монитор! Внимание! Приближается буря!
Только этого не хватало!
Точно! А сейчас давай соберись!
Внимание! Противник движется!
Okay, I need to really concentrate here. Did they just leave a line untranslated? I could have sworn I just heard somebody say hostile is down. In English. Oh my god, this Russian dub is sloppy. Wow! That has got to be the fastest yacht fight I've ever had. I mean... Wow! The sandstorm didn't even have time to clear! That was ridiculous! Where the hell am I going? Even getting lost there.
Готовься.
Oh no, wait. Whoops.
Стреляй по верёвке! Всем назад, живо!
No, I forgot.
Бежите, пока можете.
Скопи вонючий.
Катитесь отсюда! Бегом! Быстрей!
Это они!
No, not even close to world record. Definitely PB though. Definitely PB.
Вот и выход.
Вовремя.
Беги!
Слышишь, Конрад? Вот чтобы.
Definitely not world record, but absolutely PB. In order to world record, I have to beat the game in like 3 minutes.
Ну, и что будем делать?
Which
убивать все, что шевелится.
Would not happen.
Хороший план.
Готов?
Конечно. Все равно умрем.
Поехали.
Видишь, урода?
Мать твою!
Я тебе закопаю.
New strats.
Walker, shove me both of you. Come on, Walker.
Не дайте им добраться до ворот. Открыть огонь, быстро.
Он в неукрытии. Фосфор. Вали его. Ложись.
Добро пожаловать. Мы тебя ждем.
Oh, you can crouch walk during the section. I didn't know that.
Еще один долбанный залп по метру.
It's part of the OST, actually. I gotta concentrate here, because these are new strats. Nah, I probably should have killed myself there anyway. It's probably better to restart from checkpoint as soon as I hit that anyway, because it clears a lot of the enemies here. Okay, here's Lugo. Lugo? Thank you, Lugo. Okay. Final fight in the game. Completely broken by the grenade launcher. That was the final fight in the game. Yep. I didn't know that there was a grenade launcher there last time I did this run, so... Yeah, a lot of the time saves that I found here are... Yeah, because the 141.40 is the PB, is the world record. I'm not happy with this time. I want sub 140. But anyway, I'm interested to see this. Anyway, there's still time. To vote. This is your last chance to vote for the language on the next run, which hopefully I'll be able to stream later this week. But I'm definitely going to post this to my YouTube channel, because warts and all, this was a really good run. Even with the really bad parts. It won't be sub 145, which will be my next goal.
Полковник Конрад. Там, где он всегда был, сэр.
Наверху,
он ждет вас.
Yeah, make sure to vote in the straw poll for the next language.
Да-да, входи. Раз уж ты здесь, позволь мне спросить, что ты подумал, прибыв в Дубай?
What the hell? Now they don't give him the radio filter. They give him the radio filter at the beginning of chapter 11. And now they don't give him the radio filter here. What the hell? What is with this Russian dub? It's horrible.
Но мне не повезло.
Ты уверен в этом?
Абсолютно. Я не больше псих, чем ты, капитан.
Как? Джон? Это ты?
Не похож?
Я устал от игр, Джон.
Поверь мне, это... Я досчитаю до пяти и спущу курок.
Time to indulge in everybody's fantasy and kill Martin, Martin Walker.
Ты уверен? А может, мои? Раз.
Нет.
Now we'll learn how to count in Russian.
Смерти. Твоя вина.
Если ты в это веришь, стреляй. Два.
Раз, два, and what's
Никто не хотел, Уокер. Три.
145, 48, 47. Not bad. Not bad at all. I had a different split point for this, which is why I saved so much time, by the way. Because I changed my split point. But either way, I still saved a crap ton of time. And I am very happy with how that run went. 140 sub 145 is my next goal, and then eventually I'll be able to get to 140 when I stop being crap at this game. So, yay!
Это полковник Джон Конрад, армия США. Попытка эвакуации Дубая закончилась полным провалом.
Why is there no radio filter? What is with this dub? Russia, please. What is with this dub? Explain. It wouldn't bother me so much if it weren't plot important. Oh, God. Okay. Enough about the ranting about the dubs. So yeah, 145.49 is my new PB. My first PB in about 5 months. So, yay! You guys ready for a raid?